keeping in mind this is a short day, we are going to put two things together today so that we can try to help you out for your quiz coming up Friday. Part of your job on the quiz Friday is to retake some of the stuff from our tests last week so that you can actually earn the credit. Remember, I told you that you were going to see everything twice, that it would cycle through. So since tomorrow is one of those days, we are going to use today to do both modeling and formal solving and checking. So other than that, pretty much your Math Excel assignment will be cut short a little bit too, so you can use this time to kind of go back and work on the stuff that you haven't gotten to this week. But either way, a couple things that we did last Monday, or in Monday its day, was we took x plus 3 and modeled as a cup, and 3 pluses a wall, and 2 negatives. And then we solved it by getting the cup alone. The way we got the cup alone was to move 3 pluses by adding 3 minuses. Because those 0 pairs go away, a cup comes down with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 negatives. Now you have to be careful not to cancel whenever you have the same sign. The only time you cancel is whenever you have pluses and minuses, which is why you end up with 5 negatives. Over here, the objective is to get x alone. The way you get x alone is to move a plus 3 by subtracting 3. A lot of you yesterday had an issue with your fraction problem that we had, and the reason you had the issue is because you forgot that it was x plus anything. If it was x plus pi, then you would move pi by subtracting pi. If it was x plus 1/5, then you move it by subtracting 1/5. So just keep that in mind again as you go forward. Another type of problem we saw was the ones with multiple cups. 8 pluses, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Cup, and then 2x meant that we had 2 cups, remember, not 2 pluses, because that's 2 unknown amounts. And what we did with that was we simply said if there are 8 things for 2 cups, then 1 cup must have 4 things in it. And again, over here what we did was we just went ahead and said that x has to equal 4. Now of course we learned the other day that we are going to divide by 2, but again, in terms of modeling on the stuff that we do on the computer, that's as far as you need to go. And again, you're allowed to use the common sense on modeling. As long as it's not on solve and check, as long as we're not asking you to solve, show your work, then that is legitimate. Today we're going to look at problems that require two choices to find a solution, so I'm going to model this real fast. Again, 2x means 2 cups, we know that. Minus 3 means 3 negatives. Then we have a wall with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 negatives. The way that you work this problem out is you still focus on the cups themselves, and you want to get these cups alone. And the way we get these cups alone is by moving these 3 pluses, or 3 minuses. And the way we move the 3 minuses, as you know, is to put 3 pluses on both sides. So what happens is these 0 pairs cancel out. You've got 3 opposites, which means 0 pairs over here. You bring down your 2 cups with 1, 2, 3, 4 minuses. And now you are in a situation similar to what we saw on the other one, where you have 2 cups for 4 things. That means 1 cup should have 2 things. That is now a two-step equation, and that's what today is all about, is two-step equations or more, but mostly two-step equations. So over here, again, your objective is to get the cups alone. So you want to get the 2x alone, which means you need to move the negative 3 by adding 3 to both sides. 2x comes down, equaling, and again, you can draw that bar if you want. Negative 7 positive 3 is negative 4. Use your calculator if you need to. And then as we know, we divide by 2, divide by 2 to get x equals 4. Negative 4 divided by 2 is negative 2. And as you see, your two answers match. But again, this is the modeling work that you're going to have to do today to make sure you've got it. You might want to pause the video or replay it and write it down for yourself, but it's really not as bad as what it seems. You just move the chip, move the plus minuses away from the cups first, and then divide to get your cups. So I think it's easy enough to do. For the most part, just be careful. And again, just make sure you bring it up. As most of you have seen, I don't mind answering your question as we go, because it's more about the learning process than anything else to me. 2 equals 3x, which means 3 cups, plus 8. Once again, our objective is to get the cups alone. The cups are on the right, so we're going to move these 8 pluses by putting down 8 negatives, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 2 0 pairs cancel out here. Of course, all these cancel out. I'm not going to cross them out. And what happens is 6 negatives come down with three cups. And again, common sense says if there are six minuses with three cups, then one cup should have two things apiece. Solving this the algebraic way, again, focus on we want to get the variable alone or the variables alone. So the first thing we would do is move the plus 8 by subtracting 8. 2 minus 8 turns into negative 6, bringing down 3x. The next thing you do is, again, we get rid of the 3 by dividing 3. Negative 6 divided by 3 is negative 2, and that is where we get our answer that matches exactly what's over here. All right, so again, the main idea is just to make sure that you understand how to model those two. There is another modeling question that we have to look at, and it is the one that deals with negative variables. In order to model a negative variable, what we're going to do is simply turn the cup upside down. Of course, there is no upside down V on a computer, but we will use the letter A, because if you look at the A, it has a upside down V shape to it. So again, an A is your upside down cup. It represents your negative variable. So looking at a problem here, if they're asked, and you will be asked to model and solve this, negative 3x equals 6, the first thing you're going to do is put your negative 3x, which again is 3 upside down cups, equals 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now the thing about this problem is that in order to actually solve it, usually we share, but we can't put chips into a cup that's upside down. So the first thing we have to do is flip the cups over. And so we will. We'll flip all three of these cups over. But what algebra says is that if I'm going to flip the cups over, I have to flip the signs over. Now what you remember from me using these silly chips is that whenever you flip a plus over, it becomes negative, just like whenever you flip a negative over, it becomes a plus. So we can legally turn these three cups over. We just now have to turn those six positives into negatives. Now we have the problem where we say if there are six negatives for three cups, then one cup must have two negatives in it, and that is how you model this problem. Again, three negative x's, six chips. Can't see into three cups, so we turn them upside down, but if we turn this side, we must also turn that side, and then we share. Here, the way we show that is we simply flip both sides on the sign, so negative 3x becomes positive 3x equals negative 6, and of course, at that point, we divide by 3 to get x as negative 2, and again, you see that both of those answers match. So again, just remember, a negative 3x is shown with 3 upside down cups. A negative variable is shown with an upside down cup. On your modeling, though, you will use the letter A for all of those for your upside down cups, and the computer will recognize it. 7 minus 4x, so again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, bar 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and a negative x, which means that we have a upside down cup. We still want to get the cup alone, so what we will do is get the cup alone by moving these four pluses, and we move those four pluses by moving the four minuses, and of course all those zero pairs go away, leaving me three pluses and an upside down cup. And as I said, we cannot end with an upside down cup because we cannot see inside of it. So what we do is we turn this cup over, but as I hope you are learning, if you turn the cup over, you must turn the pluses over or whatever the signs are, and you end up with the answer of negative 3. In algebra, what you're going to see is that you want to move this 4 away from x. 4 is positive, so we will subtract 4. That leaves us 3 equals, and again, the issue that most students have is they write down 3 equals x, but that is a negative x, and we have to bring it down. And that is when we recognize we cannot end with a negative x, so we have to turn this x to be positive, making this 3 negative. And again, you can see those two things match. Okay. So again, that represents the four basic modeling questions you're going to see today. I am cutting those down because I'm realizing that the amount of work necessary is kind of high. But again, you are going to have to go through each of those. Just make sure that you get a good amount of practice and that you actually ask about it. I'll probably put two of each type, so either you can do two of them or you can ask for help on one and then do the other one more on your own to try to understand it. But either way, that is the overall idea. Keep in mind, our goal again is to build a strong understanding and foundation. It seems like you're doing a lot of work, but trust me when I say this, a lot of you are getting very good at this, and I see that you're on the right track. Just make sure you're asking about the things that you don't understand. So real fast, we're going to look at some of the problems in, that are not in the modeling range. These are ones that are formally solved and check. which of course the check is also going to be on your computer. And now that you have two steps, you're going to have three lines worth of check that you'll need to show on the computer. So 18 minus 6x equals negative 60. We're going to solve it first, and again, remember that our job is to get the cups, or to get to the x. The way I view it usually, again, and you can see it how you want to see it, but what I usually see it as is the closest number, if this wall is here and that number isn't included, the closest number to x is this 6, so we'll save that for last. We want to move the 18 first because we're working our way to the x from the outside in. The way you move 18 is by subtracting 18 from both sides. That cancels, it brings down a negative 6x. Negative 60 minus 18 is negative 78. There's an equal sign in between. Once again, we have a negative variable, and again, the safest way to do it, as you're going to learn later on, is to flip that sign first. I know some of you are pros and you think that it's safe to just go ahead and divide by negative 6, but what you're going to find out once we get to next week is that dividing by that negative 6 is going to cause you problems. So I suggest that you follow me for now and at least learn this method, even though you might feel like you have everything under control, because there are a lot of errors that are about to be made next week if you don't follow me here on this one. So again, negative variables, make it positive, switch both sides, and then we'll divide by 6 to get x equals, 6 goes into 7 once with 1 left over, 6 goes into 18 3 times, so x would equal 13. On your lesson credit today, you're going to have to show me all this for credit if you want your Math Excel credit, and you're going to have to do your check. Now your check, again, is taking this and plugging it into here. It's not just showing it that it equals 60. You actually are taking this equation, writing 18 minus 6 parentheses whatever x is equals the rest of that equation. I should see the version of this equation over here with that over here equaling 13. From there we get 18 minus 6 times 13 turns into 78 equals negative 60, and then you work out the left side again. 18 minus 78 gives me a negative 60 equaling negative 60, and again, this is what you're going to have to type into all of the boxes on your Math Excel. So again, what I'm doing on the Math Excel is I am making sure you know how to check. Not only that, I'm making sure you know how to go through the work to check. So again, make sure you are ready to do that. And what a lot of you are doing is you're just randomly putting stuff in. You have to follow the format. Checking means take x and plug it into here, which means if 18 minus 6x is on the left here, it should be on the left over there. It should not be flipped around and randomly treated like it's not important. Just keep that in mind. This is another type of question you need to keep an eye out for. I would actually write it down because it's important in this problem. Keeping in mind we are working our way to x from the outside in. If you imagine that wall and 18 has nothing to do with it, the furthest number from x is not 7, because 7 is actually on the top with x. The 11 is the furthest from x. And remember how we get rid of a number on the bottom is by multiplying by that number. So we will multiply both sides by 11. What happens is these two 11s cancel out. X minus 7 comes down with 198. Now, in order to get x by itself, we have a minus 7 attached. And as we've learned in the last couple days, the way you move a minus 7 is by adding 7, which brings down an x because those cancel, and 205, I believe, is what we get there. Again, that is the answer I got. Now let's check it. And again, to check it, I go back to my beginning and I simply turn my x into whatever number I got, and everything else up here stays the same. 205 minus 7 is, I think, 198. And then 198 over 11 is your 18. And again, this is what your check needs to look like if you plan on getting your credit for your Math Excel today. If you do it the wrong way, because this is the second day and I think I talked to most of you about it, you are probably going to have to do it again and show me a better version of it. So don't rush through that, because again, I know you might want to get done and just hope that I'm not looking at it, but I am really looking at it and I have to make sure you do it right. So for those of you who made that mistake yesterday, fix it. For those of you who did it fine, just keep doing it that way and you'll be fine. C, in this case, again, the closest number to x does not go first. So again, if you imagine that wall, 27 is not a part of this. the furthest number from x in this case is 65. Now I know in this problem here we said the furthest number was 11, but that's because the line went over everything. In this case, x and 13 actually make their own fraction, which means that 65 is the one that's detached. So we'll move the negative 65 by adding 65, because that's what we've learned to do over the last few days. X over 13 comes down, that cancels out. Negative 27, 65 is 8, I think it's 28. I think so, we'll see, let me take a second. Negative 27 plus 65 is 38, good thing I didn't say that. So again, we get 38 here. Now that we have 13 on the bottom, remember the way we get rid of that 13 is by multiplying both sides by 13. Those two things cancel. 38 times 13 is 494. To check it, again, make sure you do this right. You are simply taking this answer back to your original equation, except you are changing x into whatever your answer is. So 494 over 13 minus 65 equals negative 27 should be the first thing I see. If not, you're probably going to be in a group that's going to do this just for whatever purpose, just to get you used to it. 494 divided by 13, following the order of operations, is the first thing to go, which gives me 38. Minus 65 equals negative 27. 38 minus 65, of course, is negative 27 equals negative 27. And that, again, is what your check should look like. Alright. The last one we're going to look at is like this. Once again, our job is to move from the outside in. If this is x, you do not move the 2 first, you move the 9 because that is the furthest away. And so we will subtract 9 from both sides. This goes away, but be careful to recognize that this is a negative. X over 2 equals negative 12. As we did with the cups, this is a negative variable, and the best and safest thing to do is to flip both sides. Again, we are going to talk about flipping more next week. Just make sure you're practicing this process now and not, again, being stubborn, because when we throw in inequalities, it's going to cause you issues. But either way, now that we have x over 2 equals 12, we get rid of this 2 on the bottom by showing that we are multiplying by 2, bringing down x and bringing down 24. Now, to check it, we take this specific equation and we simply write everything except for x being changed into whatever it is changed into. But 9 minus x over 2 equals negative 3, and then we simply work it out. This gets changed first, which turns into 9 minus 12 equals negative 3. Of course, negative 3 is negative 3, and you have your check. All right. Once again, your lesson credit is on a worksheet. Again, be sure to show your work appropriately. Please don't try to take any shortcuts. Some of you are not getting me your sheets in time, and you're getting them to me incomplete. Just try your best to get as much as you can on them. You can use your notes. Please use the video. Use whatever notes are there. Just don't use each other. But if you don't do that, then your Math XL is not going to count. So I would hate for you to do all this work here. Also, let me explain to you that yesterday's assignment, which was 2.1b, you only need to do 7 of those. Again, 2.1b, if you've already gotten to 7, you can stop. I'm counting it at 7 because there are a lot of those solving checks. So once you get to 7, you can stop. 2.1a is still important because of the modeling part. But on 2.1b, which was yesterday's assignment, make the note that you can stop at 7. You do not need to do all 15 things. 7 is good enough. If you've already gotten to 7, that's far enough, and you can go on and start working on something else. Other than that, you do have a shortened day. Come get that sheet from my desk, and let's get to work on the Math XL after you finish that. Good luck.